Hi everyone. Today we will start the search engine optimization module of digital marketing training. Basically, SEO stands for search engine optimization, which is the practice of increasing the quantity and quality of traffic to your website through organic search results. Today is the first session of SEO, that is search engine optimization. Search engine optimization is the second and the most important module of digital marketing training. So we will start the agenda of today's session to understand what is search engine, how it works, and then you will understand how SEO works and what are the different factors, rather I must say the success factors of SEO. Then we will start with the first step of SEO, which is keyword research. Today we will just look at the introduction part of SEO. Now let's understand, what are search engines? Yes, search engine is a software that helps to search. Basically, it's a website with a search box, where once you put in the query and it returns a bunch of links or results. That is the search engine. Today if you look at the Facebook, it also has a search box. So it is called as a Facebook search engine. Even the App Store or Google Play Store, if you look at this, if you will enter a query in the search box, it will return the list of app results. So search box in the Play Store is App Store search engine. Then Google, Bing, Yahoo, all these are the different examples of search engine. In the year 1992, this was the period when different search engine was launched, like Yahoo. Slowly the number of sites starts growing. As the number of sites grown up, then Yahoo has introduced a search box. And then after, a lot of other search engines came into the market. So there are different examples of search engines like Excite, Google, Bing, and many more. You can have a look of this slide. Even MSN, Shopping.com, Yahoo, Lycos, Earthlink, AT&T, Ask.com. These all are the different examples of search engine. So all these search engines were introduced between 1992 to 1994. Then in the year 1998, a big revolution happened when Google was launched. And you can say that Google came into the picture, practice project by Larry Page and Search Brain. Google began its journey in the year 1996 as a research project by Larry Page and Sergey Brin, when they were both doing PhD from Stanford University in California. Then after the launch, they wanted to do some enhancement. For that, they used an algorithm which will run behind the scene. And after each query raised, means Google is an algorithm-based search engine. So on the basis of algorithm, you see the pages on the SERP, that is search engine result page. I hope you get my idea. Now let's understand what is crawling. Every search engine has to perform three basic operations, or three basic functions rather I must say. Crawling, indexing, and ranking. Firstly, I am going to explain about the crawling part. So Larry and Sergey Brin keep on doing enhancement, and they reach to that level that now approximately 80 to 88% user they explore only through Google. When Google was launched, it defines three major functions of a search engine. The first one was crawling, second indexing, and the third one was ranking. And every search engine has to perform this function in order to generate the SERP. Let me show you practically what you need to go do. You just go there and type, let's say Shimla packages or vacations. So these are the different results based on to the keyword that I have input into the search bar of the Google. Now you can have a look. These are the paid advertisement as ad is written over there. Now this is the organic search result. Got the point? This one. These are the organic search result. These are the just newbies in the field of website. So this is the SERP page, search engine result page. Whatever result comes is in front of you. It is the SERP. Paid advertisement, they always appear at the top or even at the bottom, right? So let's understand this function of search engine one by one. To understand the crawling, take the example of real spider in your mind. What this spider does basically? Yes, it crawls, weaves web, catches the prey even, crawls over the wall and creates the web finally. And whatever is coming across the web, it catches all of that. So consider search engine crawler as a spider. So that is why this convention is also popularly used, that crawler is also called as a spider or even bot. So crawler is that software that helps search engine to show result or SERP. So crawler crawl over the internet. So what happens? The minute we make our website live, all the URL, uniform resource locator, or simply we can say the hyperlink or links of a site, they are pushed to a URL queue over the internet. So what this crawler do? Crawler crawls this URL queue day and night. When they crawl these URL, they extract the information from the URLs and store this information into the database. So every search engine has its own database. Okay? So this function is called as a crawling. Crawling URLs of website and extracting information from these URLs and storing it into the database is known as a crawling function. Is everybody clear with the crawling function? Make my trip. This is the travel website. It has different packages. Now you look at this, there are different information that is available on this page, right? Every page has its own URL. Now you look at this, the moment I click on this, it is showing me that makemytrip.com hotels, village and all, right? Depending upon the, you know, kind of links. Next comes indexing. Now this database which was created in the crawling phase, it's too big. As crawler does work day and night, 24/7 format, it crawls different pages and extract the information and store it into the database. So when they do it, crawler puts the information into the right segment of the database. Right? You got my point? So let's understand it. The moment you click on any link. When crawler will crawl this site, it will get an idea that this website is giving them all the different information regarding travel only, as there are lot many travel blogs are also there. There is no other information. Everything is related to travel only. Now, makemytrip.com reflects information regarding domestic, national, international packages. So, crawler will extract this information and will store it into the right segment of database. It will explore the information regarding Singapore, Bangalore, Jaipur, and keep it into the separate database, separate segment of the database. Right? So, moving the data to the right segment of search engine database is the function of indexing. Is that clear, everyone? Guys, are you clear now? Remember, the software search engine that helps the search to crawl is called as a crawler or spiders or bots. Shall we move ahead? Quickly say yes or no. Okay. Now, let's understand ranking. This is the third function of search engine. Now, imagine crawler crawls millions of web pages every day and keep adding information to its database every single second. Now, let's take the example of Google. Since it was introduced in the year 1998, till now, Google's database will be very, very huge or big. Right? So, how the Google will decide which result to show at the top and which one to show at the bottom? Google crawler would have stored lots of URL into the database. Now, this is to be decided which result should be displayed at the top and which one to bottom. So, for deciding this particular thing regarding the placement of result, Google's algo come into the picture. Google's algo is what basically it includes the rules that helps the Google crawler to decide what pages it should show for the top placement and what for the bottom of the SERP based on to the algo or algorithm. So whatever pages has qualified the highest number of factor of that algo will be shown at the top of the SERP, and the pages or the web pages who have not passed will not be shown at the bottom. Although there are more than 200 factors to decide the page rank of a web page, right? So that part is called as a ranking. Now look at this site. These are the different sites. The moment you click on any link, like this, different packages are there. Singapore, Indonesia, it will show you, take you to the that page. Right, Singapore and this one. Similarly, now look at this. I am going to click on this part. Now this link is taking me away from other website. You can have a look onto the URL of this link. NASCOM community. Now this site is having a external link. The pickyourtrail.com is having a link with the external link, that is NASCOM. So the key functions of Google are crawling, indexing and ranking. I hope you all are clear on this part. Now, let's go through with the how Google works basically behind the scene. So in this regard, the first point is Google must first find your content. After crawling your site, they must come into the index pages. Your site must come into the index pages and ultimately rank them with a greater index. To understand the entire concept, let's see the video also. This is really a very wonderful video, and you will get a glimpse of the thing that how the search engine works basically. Right? So let's see the video. Now you will be able to get the idea about how do search engine work. Spider or crawler crawls the web pages of the website and extract the information from the web pages and store it into the right segment of the database. So for deciding the placement of the result onto the SERP page, Google's algo come into the picture. Google's algo is a kind of rules that helps the Google crawler to decide what pages it should show on the top of the placement and what should be at the bottom of the SERP, based onto the algo only. So one of the important factor of this algo is page rank. Now look at this diagram and consider every circle as a separate website and guess what it depicts. Is it not looking like a network? Yes, it is a linking network. This linking network reflects that how, as I have told you, that consider every circle as a separate website. So site C is associated with B, F is also associated with B, E is associated with B and F, and even D. D is associated with B and A is not connected with anyone. Now coming back to the PageRank concept, the PageRank also depends on this networking. How the things are connecting. Now what is PageRank? Google assigns score to every web page that it crawls. If Google has crawled 10 different pages of your website, then Google will assign certain score to every page. Okay, this score will be out of 10. We cannot see this score by means of any tool because Google does not disclose it. Right? So once your rank starts better in the search engine or SERP, that means your page rank is also improving. So now this page rank also depends on lots of factor, and the first factor is page rank. One of the factor is links of the pages. Now I am going to take a very simple example that will convey my point to you. Consider you have rupees 100 in your hand. This is the rule of your house to give rupees 10 to each one of the family member or each one of. So page rank must be considered just like the money, just for the sake of example. Assume page rank as 8 out of 10. By Google now, as per the example, simple funda or rule of page is that whatever pages or links are added to this page, some percentage of page rank of this page will be passed on to these links also. So if the 8 is a page rank of this page, now assume about 10 links are added to the page when according to Google, 0.01 rank of this page will be passed on to all the 10 links. So what will happen to the page rank of this page? If the portion of a page rank is passed on to each link, then each link will it improve or decrease? Yes, the page rank of this page will definitely be affected. Rather, I must say that the page rank of this page will be decreased. Similarly, if the links that you have added are the website link, page rank will stay within the same page or web page. If the so, So page rank will stay within the same page if internal pages are interlinked. But if page rank will be shared with the external link, then it will be shared also. So linking your website with external link will affect the page rank, as a portion of page rank of your page will be shared among those external pages, right? So we can summarize that a single website is a different collection of web pages, and every web page is a collection of different hyperlinks, and different hyperlinks, they will share the page rank. So the page rank of this page will be distributed among the 10 links, right? Page rank is web page oriented rather than website oriented. So first rule is, whatever links are added to your page or web page, some portion of that page rank will be passed on to these links also. Second rule is, whatever percentage is passed on to these links, your own website link, then your page rank will stay within the same web page. But if these links are external site, then your page rank will be actually go down, and you have actually lost page rank in that case. So these are the two simple rules of page rank. I am taking one example that I have just shown you. In this example, this is a page, pickyourtrail.com. Here every page is sharing page rank of this page. It will, here the page rank will stay within the same site, and it will be shared among different pages, right? Now if, like I have taken this one, this NASCOM is an external link. Here the page rank will be shared. You can have that this is a separate community. Even you can check it out from the URL also, right? So in this case, the page rank will be reduced. How do search engine works? The entire scenario is there in front of you. Crawl budget we have just spoke about. The three key function of search engine now, as you know that Google has to crawl billions of websites every single second. So ultimately it is a program, as it has its own limitation. So what it does, whatever website it crawls, it does not crawl all the pages. So in order to do best crawling, it allocates its time to every website for crawling. For example, if Google comes to your website or PCTI website for crawling, it will give 1 second only, right? So what will happen in this 1 second, it will crawl all the pages during this period. So amount of time allocated by crawler to crawl a site is the crawl budget. And it is your duty, being an SEO professional of the site or as a webmaster of the site, to use crawler budget in the right manner. Which means, when crawler crawls your website, right, you should cross only the important pages of your website. Let's say there is a website who talks about aerobics, exercise, diet plan and different yoga packages also. And when crawler crawls this site during crawl budget, it crawls those pages where instructor or trainer details is reflecting, right? So their personal details like email ID, contact number and qualification, it is much more the key information of the trainer only, right? So if you are the owner of this site, would you like to talk about the trainer details only to the crawler, right? Rather than, your idea is to show relevant information, so that what will happen if the crawler will crawl only the trainer detail rather than the key relevant information. Let's assume your site has 120 pages and 40 pages it talks only about the trainer or personal information of the trainer, rather than the aerobics packages and other facilities that your center is offering, right? So now further assume that during crawl budget, out of 50 pages crawled by the crawler, 30 pages were of trainer personal details only. Now these pages will start coming in the ranking, but all of these was an intention. You never wanted to show these pages in the search result. And in turn, what has happened? You have violated the trainer's privacy and wasted the crawl budget also. So what we can do, we can define instruction for the crawler that when you come to my site, crawl only these pages. Or you should not crawl these pages when crawler will find those instruction. Then crawler will follow these instruction and crawler will utilize that 1 second as a crawl budget in the best possible manner. Now defining the instruction for the crawl budget is called as a optimization. I'm repeating, defining the instruction for the crawl budget is called as a optimization. There are different ways to optimize a crawl budget. I will explain these ways later part of the session. Everybody is clear on crawl budget optimization? Now there are different strategies that must be followed to optimize a crawl budget. There are few things that you should keep in mind during optimization. I am taking one example of, you know, Pixlr.com. This is a photo editing site which allow you to do certain changes onto the photo part once you registered with that. But before going ahead on that part, it allow you to download the Flash software first. Now look at this. The moment I have clicked on this site, it take me to the Enable Flash Player. Please click here. Now imagine, being a human being, I can do it. But what if the same is being told to crawler? Do you think that crawler will do it on your behalf? Of course not. So, site will ask for the installation of Flash software first. Being a human, you can do it. Think Google or crawler will do it? No, not at all. So, crawler will stuck here. An entire crawl budget will also spend in this downloading operation. Crawler will not proceed further. So we have basically wasted our crawler's time completely. So Google say if you want the crawler to crawl your pages smoothly, then make sure not use any rich media files for Flash file. Next is to build sufficient internal and external links, so that crawler can come to your site through this network also. Next comes broken links. Sometimes we come across the pages and find broken links. This error is not good from SEO point of view. So there is no point in crawling such pages with the broken links. There are some languages like RSS, XML and Atom easily crawled by the Google. Google make use of all these file types and ensure every page must be crawlable. You got my point? Now you can have a look that always avoid using rich media files or Flash files. Build internal and external links in a very judicial way. Always check, have a check on to the page rank of the links with which your site is going to be connected. Internal and external link, you can get the idea from this snapshot that there are two domains. Domain A, when it is interlinked within the same site, different pages of the same site, when they are interlinked together, then it is called as internal linking. And when a site is connected with the third party or external site, it is called as an external linking. There is a differentiation between external and internal link. Yes, external links are difficult to control, while internal links are easy, fast and free to create. In case of external link, SEO pass the authority from other site to your site, increasing your domain authority. While in case of internal link, SEO authority passes between pages on your site and increases the page authority of some specific pages. So I hope you get an idea that what is the basic difference between the internal and external link. If you find such kind of error. So broken links are those on your site that point to non-existent resources. This can be internal or even external. Right? So we must avoid all these scenarios from the SEO point of view. Optimizing for bots or for users. So in this regard, Google has a idea that if your website is not optimized for the user experience, then I'm sorry to say it is not fit for my crawling. Or we can say, then you have to improve on this part so that I can crawl. In simple terms, we can say this. So optimizing for search engine bots like Google bot, Bing bot, right? So we have to optimize a crawl budget. It falls under the regular technical site maintenance. Optimizing your website for user means SEO basically. Right? So search engine optimization, it takes into the consideration of user interface, user experience towards the website and all how he navigate. So always remember that Google asks to all the SEO professionals that if you are doing the SEO of any site, if that site is user friendly in context of users, then only the crawler will come to your site, otherwise not. Right? So that's all for today. If you have any query, please email your queries at query@pcti.ltd.com. You can always share your issues and concern over this. Thank you. Wish you a very happy learning. Bye-bye. See you.